response, that it's really very reasonable and logical that we are also on the social nets. So I invite all of you to join the social nets, to come to visit Tatarstan and see it by your own eyes, and to invest, of course. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you. This is Minullina. We know, we all of us, we knew that Tatarstan was very dynamic, but now, thanks to you, we are convinced more again about that. So thanks for your presentation. Now I would like to give the floor to Mr. Vice Prime Minister, Mr. Waman Shaikuddinov, who will speak about information technologies and high-tech projects in Tatarstan.
Thanks a lot. Bonjour. Guten Tag. Good morning. Buongiorno. I'm representing the information technology block, but actually information technology is covering all spheres of all kind of activity, whether this is sports, whether this is health, production, even the car driving, and we see this is a big trend that is coming. Republic of Tatarstan is driving now a new sphere. It's a digital economy and digital transformation. We are defined, we defined 10 issues that embraces government management, which includes e-services, e-government, and e-documentation flow system. Digital commerce, education, that is a basis for the big penetration of education is information technologies. Digital healthcare, digital construction and housing and utilities, digital geospace, because it's very important to locate all kind of facilities that you have, all kind of products that you have, people, dogs, kids, cars, production plants, agriculture, rescue teams, a lot of things. Digital economy, normative base, this is Tatarstan is participating in a special group that is developing certain laws that will be applicable, and ICT security. So coming back to the infrastructure, a couple of words. We have IT park. This is a techno park that specializes in cultivation, in attraction of IT companies and startups in information technology sphere. It's two techno parks that is located, one is locating in the capital of Tatarstan, Kazan, which is 30,000 square meters, and it was built up back in 2009, and IT park in Chelny, that was built up in 2012 and 25,000 square meters. It's 151 IT companies. It's more than 3,000 IT staff employees. The revenue is 12 billion rubles. It's very interesting that it's more than 400 different software products that we are exporting abroad to 16 countries. For 2017, export from our residents, from our IT companies, exceeded 360 million rubles. We also have data center, business incubator, a co-working, hotel. We have a special project in education in IT sphere, which is IT Academy. And we have a new project, IT Solutions, that supports the export of IT. And we're also very open to discuss with Swiss companies, the companies based in Swiss, on the collaboration for the staff. We have very smart staff, qualified, and not 25 francs per hour, which is a minimum, as I understand, here in Swiss. The data center will not take much time. It's just one of the biggest, with the participation of, it's one of the biggest, it's 1,000 square meters. And this is certified to tier 3 level, which suits insurance companies, banks, and fintech companies, which is very high. The business incubator, those one who has investments in new startups and new companies, please come to see, and I invite you to come to Kazan, to Tatarstan, whether with delegation or separately, to come and see which companies we are developing. And the startups are also open to discuss and to see investors, or ready to participate in common projects that are implementing in Switzerland. The other big project, which Mr. President already mentioned, this is a special economic zone that is a part of a new Russian city, Annapolis, that has three main core activities. This is the new Russian university in computer science, a special economic zone that supports IT companies and new startups, and this is high quality environment for life. Just some figures on Annapolis. Annapolis is a new city, as I said. It includes, it's located on the 1,200 hectares. Now it is about 5,000 people, and this just 40 kilometers from Kazan. The basic infrastructure already finished in construction, and it's open for any IT companies that may come. This I will see a few slides further. Annapolis University today is just 5 years university, but it's already ranked as a top five Russian IT universities. It's because we have very tough and interesting team of the professors and of the students. It's more than 30 applications per one place to be in the university. It's very high. It's 556 students now. And what is more important, it's academic and research venue of, on the picture, residence venue, and the sports venue. But what is more important, this is education and research team of the top scientists, and it's an international team. If somebody does not see, it's people that come from United States, from Switzerland. Bertrand Meyer, maybe somebody of you know this, it's very well known professor in Switzerland. Giancarlo Succi, it's dean and of the Faculty of Computer Science and head of Laboratory of Industrial and Production Software. So this international team is not only developing education, it's mostly developing an industry project. The projects that are oriented to develop a certain and practical industrial. So this is just a sample of several projects. It's more than 1.2 billion rubles in attracted. One project is the project with Kamaz for the robotics car. Another project is a complex for autonomous robot assembly area and some other. Android Technics, this is developing a complex that it's a cross-country terrain driving. Everybody developing the cars that are drives on the asphalt, on the roads, but nobody developing cars that are driving off-road. And it's a special project that also includes a car and the drone that are going together, and it's immediate mapping. It's a unique project. I'm sure we didn't find any such projects that we were trying to. Other projects it's, that is financed by Russian Science Foundation, by National Technology Initiative, by Gazprom, by we have also new startup developing concept of designing a unified information source. Very interesting projects. Why I mention these projects is that we're inviting, whether your investments, whether your partners, whether your companies that maybe you know, to come to develop, and this is a special place to develop, and this is a special economic zone that, or technopark, that is ready to accommodate whether remotely, whether on the basis of the joint venture, whether on the basis of your shareholders or your company members will come to settle down in Tatarstan. Or we can make common projects without any, let's say, incorporation of the companies. But what is important in the special economic zone, this is zero corporate tax, This is just 16% insurance payments, though all over the Russia this is 30.6, and this is very cheap office space in the first technopark. It less than 20 francs. So these are some of the companies. This is quite big. So far now in Innopoly City is 176 companies, and 78 companies are already in Innopolis. What I want to say is that Tatarstan has very high, not very high, but bigger than the other regions of Russian Federation, share in gross regional product from ICT. We totally have 32,000 people working in ICT, and this is more than 1,700 IT companies. So it's quite big number. Not big enough, because we have other projects with education. So these are some of the big companies. And some of the companies are top one in Russia. Sberbank, for example, this is number one in fintech. Acronis is number one in the data security and the data management. Gazprom, you know, Kaspersky, you know also, this is information security that also has a big activity in Switzerland. So this is Eugene Kaspersky. He is coming from time to time to Kazan, to Innopolis. This is first technopark. It's Acronis office in Innopolis. And very important, this is a comfortable environment for life. It's apartment houses and townhouses available. Now, by the support of the Republic, of the President of the Republic, we're developing a household project, which is also very important. So, just four benefits for the collaboration with Tatarstan. Tatarstan might be a good gate and path to Russia and CIS. We are ready to follow and to introduce you staff attracting and cheaper than Moscow, a big city in Russia, and for sure cheaper than in Europe. But cheap does not bad, and cheap for you, but it's applicable for our taxation system and for our market, according to Russian market. Innopolis University competences, this is specialized laboratories and research, manpower, it's free internship for students, outsourcing of research staff and university professors, whether on the basis on the industrial projects, whether on on the tuition projects. And also tax benefits and infrastructure in IT park and special economic zone. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Mr. Shankudino, for this presentation. Now I would like to give the floor to Mr. Nicola Higley. Nicola Higley is the Director General of the Economic Development here in Geneva. He's also is a person really interested by high tech, IT and research, so high tech business.
Thank you so much for the introduction. Voyagez mi, господин президент Тарстана, дорогие гости, здравствуйте. Добро пожаловать в Женеву. Я очень рад приветствовать вас в нашем городе. I think I will stop here because my English is slightly better than my Russian. But I'm delighted to be here with you today to just give you an insight into Geneva as a business location. But first of all, I'd like to rebound on the weather factor. I'm tremendously happy you enjoy the sunshine today. And if the temperature is slightly higher here than in Kazan, and you can enjoy it for a day or two, it's absolutely brilliant. Anyway, Geneva, why is it the prime business location in the heart of Europe? I'm trying to get this going. Why is it not working? Here we go. Okay. I got it. I can do it manually. Anyway, what is Geneva about? Geneva is this very special ecosystem where you essentially have so many people from all over the world. And there we are very comparable to Tatarstan. Your colleague mentioned the fact that so many nationalities were present in Tatarstan. We have about 200 different nationalities present in Geneva. 40% of the inhabitants are foreigners here, so there is an enormous amount of multicultural exchanges. But more than that, I think what's really making this place a very special one is the compactness of it. You can essentially, in a very small territory, find here international organizations, about 40 of them, an enormous amount of companies, and world-class academic excellence. And this you can combine with very high quality of life, and maybe relevant, or hopefully relevant, when it comes to the relationship between Geneva and Russia, a very, very long tradition of friendship between this city, between Geneva citizens and Russian citizens, dating back essentially to Peter the Great. Let's not forget, it's a Geneva citizen, Pierre Lefort, who essentially built Peter the Great's navy. So a very long tradition and a very vibrant Russian community here in Geneva. So Geneva is a global hub for players, and what we see now more and more is that people come here because of R&D, innovation, how to essentially bring their products upwards in the value added chain. This is what this place is about, innovation, IP. Obviously, we also have a great financial hub here in Geneva, and trade with the World Trade Organization, but also with this great commodities trading hub is absolutely of prime importance. This has resulted in many global companies establishing here. We have about 900 different multinationals headquartered here in Geneva. And these are essentially thriving here from Geneva through the whole of European, Middle Eastern, and African region. Banking and finance, I mentioned it. This is a very, very large activity still, with more than 100 banks present here in Geneva. Not just the classical wealth management anymore, world-class services coming from asset management, but also trade financing, sustainable finance, which is growing. So a very, very vibrant fintech, I should obviously mention as well, very vibrant financial community. Commodity trading, I have to get there. We are honored to host a lot of Russian companies in this field. So that is another one of our key clusters. When it comes to high-tech elements, we obviously are a global center for life sciences and medical technologies. We have here as well, a very vibrant sector. This is now moving into brain tech, how to mix essentially artificial intelligence with life sciences, how to move to the next stage in these fields. This is where these things happen here. IT is very strong as well. This is probably coming from the fact that we have CERN, this great physics international hub here, but also a lot of companies present in this field of activity from everywhere. We are at the present specializing especially in cyber security. The World Economic Forum just decided to build its cyber security center, the global cyber security here in Geneva. We have started the Geneva Digital Talks to make sure we have a global framework around these issues. So this is a place to be if you're in this sphere.
Obviously, we still have some other sectors like watchmaking. This is probably not coming as a surprise to any of you. Maybe less well-known aroma and fragrances, perfumes. This is the place where essentially the most subtle perfumes are researched and developed out of Geneva. Sanitation economy is growing out of this as well. Maybe a bit of a word about tax. There is a tax reform going on in Switzerland. This is not yet complete, but the government is essentially committed to move tax to 13.49% when it comes to corporate net profit tax rate. So this is something we are working on. Hopefully we can, by the end of 2019, early 2020, move towards there. So, easy access to Europe, security, stability, quality of life, proactive authorities. The link with the political authorities is very, very strong. That's very important for companies. If there is any issue, anything we can do, we are very, very reactive. There is, hopefully, a good brand image, a very international and vibrant hub, excellent infrastructure, and obviously all of the services that go with it. But at the end of the day, and I think that was mentioned by my counterpart in Tatarstan as well, it's really about people. It's really about talent. It's about people essentially being productive, being innovative, and making a difference when it comes to creating value for companies. I wanted, and I hope it will work here, I wanted to show you a little bit of a movie, because we are moving forward on innovation especially. There is a very big drive. Hopefully we can get this to work. Again, I don't know, here we are. Is there no one? I can't see it here, and I can't see it there. Great, technology is fantastic.
Partnership.
Much more advanced cooperation with Tatarstan. Really, technology is not where it should be here. Here we go. This is the traditional side of Geneva, the one you know, and we will get into innovative things now. This is a short presentation to illustrate, thank you so much, to illustrate this drive towards innovation here we have in Geneva. This is fundamental to us. We believe we have so many stakeholders here in Geneva from an academic point of view, from a business point of view, from a governance point of view, from a civil society point of view. What will happen if these different stakeholders start to work together? We believe that's where we have a competitive advantage in essentially moving forward on innovation. And so the Director General I'm leading is essentially facilitating this cooperation between different clusters, different actors, so that at the end of the day, everybody gets to be better off. So let's see if I can get back to the slides, to the last one. How do I move this forward again? Here we go. Yeah, excellent. Last slide. So what will we do? We essentially try to make sure we have this innovation happening in between different clusters, in between international organizations and business, bringing in academia, linking research, both fundamental and applied to businesses, and seeing how this can add value here. Otherwise, what we do is we obviously support and guide the businesses through the administrative processes. We provide expertise at the fiscal, legal, and employment level. Make sure we facilitate people wanting business here in Geneva. I think that's the key message I wanted to provide to you. Once again, thank you so much for your presence. I'm looking forward to follow-up conversations, and спасибо большое.
So thank you, Nicola, for this presentation. I recognize my computer, so that's a good presentation. Thanks, and also for giving some human factor to all this high-tech. Experiences and projects. Now I would like to give the floor to our last speaker, Mr. Hergé Rousse. Mr. Rousse is the Vice President of the Burkhardt Congress in the Middle East and Eastern region, and he will speak also about the high-tech project.
Esteemed Mr. President, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for having a chance to introduce and say a little bit about our company, Burkhardt Compression. I feel also as a guest because we are from east-north part of Switzerland, we are from Canton Zurich. And I will not be speaking about IT, about the 22nd century ideas. I will be talking about very traditional mechanical products. We are a company which produces reciprocating compressors. I don't know how many of you know what reciprocating compressor is, but I hope to show you what we can do for the industry. We are a company which has been established in 1844. As I said, we are close to Zurich in Winterthur, and here you can see our production in Switzerland. We have 36,000 square meters of production that we produce our equipment, which is reciprocating compressors. Our reciprocating compressors look like that. We are starting from very standard high pressure small compressors through the very unique oil-free frictionless labyrinth compressors, through the horizontal standard compressors, up to the very specific product hypercompressors. Maybe the question is why I am here and why I'm talking about it. These are the segments where these reciprocating compressors are used. And during the previous presentations, we heard and we learned that Tatarstan actually is a big, big economy for oil and gas. This is where we can use our compressors, and this is showing that compressors are used through all the oil life cycle. However, I have a feeling that this is a little bit too technical, so to have a good imagination, this is where you can find reciprocating compressors. So actually in every single production company. Our company is not only producing new compressors, but we are also working on aftermarket. This means checking and keeping life cycle of the compressors for a very, very long time. So this means we are working with very old equipments also, and this is our knowledge which we can propose also to the oil and gas industry. I hope that for at least some of you, we are not unknown. We are already having our equipment in some of the companies in Tatarstan. You see that we have 22 compressors. We are working quite a long time, having a good relationship because of our business partner from sitting in Moscow, company Novotex, also here. And just last week, we were visiting, or our specialists with our business partner were visiting this company, Kazakh Orsintes, to investigate if there would be a possibility to change and to make a modification. Means increase the pressures to be able to make a new product. This is something what we can propose and offer. If you have a changes need for the re-rating or any life cycle issues, we can work on that. We are also in Nizhnekamsk Neftekhim, where you are using this oil-free labyrinth compressors, but of course in all other oil and gas refineries and petrochemicals, you are having many of these reciprocating compressors. And this is what we would like to propose, and we see a chance to move Switzerland from this not very nice 28th position of the partnership with Tatarstan, but to get us a little bit higher. We are proposing to coordinate visits of your compressor users to make an investigation of the conditions and work on the improvements. This means this is an alternative for the investments. You don't need to all the time buy a new compressors. We can also help you on modifications via modernizations of all existing equipment. When I was asked to think about what we can propose, what the cooperation should be about, this is something what we are seeing as a potentials. We can think, we saw a nice presentation of this strategy 2030 about ecology, about growth, about health. This is exactly what we can do with old equipments. We can make them reliable, very well performing, and safety and environment friendly again. What we can also, with the IT related, we can make kind of digitalization. We have a company in our portfolio which is providing the online monitoring of all the equipment, so you can see remote in your Innopolis, for example, how all the compressors are operating, so we can predict all the essential issues. How do we see that? As a potential cooperation, we are proposing, and I hope to have a chance further to discuss about the details, we are proposing to make, let's call it working group, to go to assess all the old equipments and to give you the ideas how these machineries can be innovated, how these machines can be modernized to do it. And of course, we already heard about the localizations. We are ready to invest also for the service centers to give the know-how closer to the end users, to help your maintenance teams to develop, to get a new processes and technologies. So I hope this was very shortly about Burkhardt compression and the possibilities we can offer, and I would like very happy to see further potentials for cooperation between not only Switzerland but also Burkhardt compression and Tatarstan. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your presentation. So now we are coming to the end of the official presentations, but before to go to the cocktail, we have also an official two official things to do. We have to sign two agreements, and I would like to call my colleague from Kazan, Mr. Agiev, to sign the agreement between the Chamber of Commerce of Tatarstan and the Union Chambers of Commerce Switzerland.
Для подписания соглашения о сотрудничестве между Союзом торговых палат Швейцарии, России и стран СНГ и Союзом торгово-промышленной палаты Республики Татарстан приглашаются Шамиль Рахимович Агеев, председатель Союза торгово-промышленной палаты Республики Татарстан, и Гей Метан, президент Союза торговых палат Швейцарии, России и стран СНГ. to sign an agreement on cooperation between the joint Swiss-Russia and CIS Chamber of Commerce and the Chamber of Commerce of the Republic of Tatarstan, we invite Shamil Agayev, Chairman of the Chamber of Commerce of the Republic of Tatarstan, and Guy Mettan, President of the joint Swiss-Russia and CIS Chambers of Commerce. Подписание соглашений о намерениях между технопарком Инопарк и технопарком в сфере высоких технологий IT-парк приглашаются Франсуа Агер, генеральный директор технопарка Инопарк Suisse SA, и Антон Олегович Грачев, директор технопарка в сфере высоких технологий IT-парк. To sign an agreement of intent between Inopark Technopark and Technopark in the sphere of high technologies IT-парк, we invite Франсуа Агер, General Director of the Technopark Inopark Suisse SA, and Anton Grachov, Director of the Technopark in the sphere of high technologies IT Park. In Geneva, 23rd of March. Congratulations.
Thank you.